How would you like to build your cash flow by 60, 70, even 80% or more, year after year in a fraction of the time you spend creating it with your business? How would it feel to know that, no matter what the global economy has planned for you financially, that you can insulate yourself? How about the peace of mind that comes with having a realistic way to catch up on what you haven't put back for life after business without having to sell your business first? I'm Kevin L. Jefferson, founder and father of the Forex Fam, where we teach business owners how to build exponential cash flow for business and life after business, so that when they're ready to do something else or keep going, they can do so without sacrificing their lifestyle. Before I get too far into it, let me share with you a bit about myself. I'm a public school product from Dallas, Texas, and when I graduated high school, I attended college in New York, graduating from the United States Military Academy at West Point, and I served in the Army as a field artillery officer, getting to visit such tropic beauties as Southwest Asia and Kuwait before leaving for corporate life. I'm a husband to the most amazing wife and a dad to two outstanding sons. We love creating new memories, and I'm grateful that I have been blessed with the flexibility and time freedom to be a constant presence in the lives of my loved ones. So why do I care? I've been successful enough to not ever have to worry about getting another client or business deal or anything. But I remember early in my professional career wishing I had someone with the business stripes who I could count on as a mentor to help me grow as an entrepreneur. And that was very frustrating for someone who had the means and the motivation, but lacking that mentorship. I remember the joy I had in this early part of my life as a cadet and young officer. And although I had been successful up to this point, I still found myself wanting more for my life. My first job post-military was as a management trainee, for Georgia Pacific Corporation, where we made fancy boxes in the corrugated and packaging division. Super sexy, I know. I'm grateful for this first opportunity, though, because it really opened my eyes to so much as it relates to business. I learned customer service, design, shipping, scheduling, manufacturing, maintenance, quality control, process improvement, and so many other things. I also learned that there are a lot of ways to make money in business. The first year I was with this paper product manufacturing company, they made over $22 billion in sales. That's over 20 years ago from today. Wow. I also learned that you are not your job. So many people I met in my time in corporate, whether it was in a plant or in an office, almost to a person, they believed that they were whatever their job was. Let me give you an example. I met very few production schedulers who could actually go out and work the machines they were scheduling. The first thought, of course, is, well, that's what they do. They're a scheduler. In my mind, the first thought is, they are a person who knows how to schedule. I saw a person's job as their job, and I saw them as a human separate from that. But why is this even important? It's important because there are so many people who, in the course of their lives, take on the persona of the type of work that they do. The challenge with this is that when you identify yourself only by what you do, you subconsciously solidify what you can, can't, will, or won't do to accomplish your goals. What if learning how to run a machine offered twice as much money, but the trade-off was that work jeans and a t-shirt became the new uniform over khakis and a polo? What if getting a little sweaty versus an air-conditioned office was a small price that had to be paid for obtaining those big financial goals everyone dreams about? The human mind is built for self-preservation, and so whatever we choose to believe, the mind works overtime to make that narrative true, even to the detriment of what's factual. Let me give you an example. When someone says, I'm not good at math, consciously they might feel as though they would truly love to be better at math, but the crazy thing is, the mind has already taken that affirmation and started putting things in place to support the I'm not good at math belief statement. Have you ever tried a certain food, and when you first tasted it, you liked it, but when you found out what it was, you couldn't bring yourself to eat it again? Your brain is working under the affirmation that you believe that certain food is supposed to be nasty, unclean, or undesirable. So your brain boxes out any narrative that supports information to the contrary. And so you may never expand your palate simply because of the beliefs you formed around certain foods, even without direct experience. The same is true when it comes to business and what's possible. Ownership is about more than money. It's about time freedom, autonomy, the ability to fail or succeed on your own terms. In fact, the number one reason most people start their own business is the freedom, satisfaction, and flexibility it offers them. And although that's wonderful, the numbers say that a significant number of businesses aren't doing the type of revenue to keep the dream of business ownership from becoming a nightmare. Let me share some numbers with you. The number of non-employer businesses, that is businesses without employees except the owner, their average annual revenue was $46,978. 1 to 4 employees, $387,000. 5 to 9 employees, a little over $1 million. 10 to 19 employees, over $2.1 million in average annual revenue. 21 to 99 employees, a little over $7.1 million. And 100 to 499 employees in the business make over $40 million in average annual revenue. So the moral of the story is that it's clear that to survive and thrive as a business owner, you need a team. But to get a team, you need capital. The challenge is, businesses cite lack of cash flow as the main reason they cannot sustain. Instead of enjoying the things that they want to be thinking about with their business, most entrepreneurs and business owners are instead dealing with a lack of time to enjoy life and family, etc., due to the business demands. Or they're dealing with scaling issues because they find themselves working in their business more than on their business. Scaling is also an issue for a number of business owners because of a lack of talented people to help move the vision forward. Never mind the issues and challenges that come with employees and contractors. And although many business owners do not state money as the main reason for starting their business, money is a lot like blood. It may make you uncomfortable to think about it, but no one can deny that without it, you won't live very long. So even if money is not the main motivation, you still need to make sure that your quote-unquote blood bank has ample supply if you want your business to have a chance to survive or thrive. So keep that in mind when people tell you that money isn't everything. As a business owner, you understand money is the only thing. As one who's been in finance for 20 years and who has with my team cared for over $100 million in financial assets, I have a keen understanding of this concept. I started my financial service career right after September 11th, 2001, which was until maybe recently arguably the worst time to become a financial advisor. I remember so much about where I was the day before and the day of that event. The day before, I was on vacation in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and had just completed a real estate purchase. When I left breakfast the next morning to celebrate, I was hearing radio reports of a major event, but I was confused. When I arrived back at my hotel, I was watching the lobby television and saw the second plane hit. There was so much emotion on so many levels. As a former soldier, and as a citizen, even as a businessman, you see, I had just resigned from my job to go into financial services. There are no words for what was going through me at that moment. Instead of treating it like a hindrance, I treated the uncontrollable circumstances as an opportunity to break out of the box of what a stockbroker should look like and what types of products they should offer their clients. I had to be super creative to survive in the financial services business early on, so I found creative ways to get in front of clients. My first year as a stockbroker with Merrill Lynch, I did millions in mortgage refi business as opposed to pitching stock ideas because that's what entrepreneurship, i.e. survival, required of me. That perspective has served me well as I've gone on to create one of my own successful financial services company and several others, including the amazing $30 million plus enterprise that I currently own. I'm going to share with you the exact process that my clients use to create cash flow for their business, so that you can do the same thing without spending lots of time doing it. I'm also going to share with you the 5 reasons most entrepreneurs fail to grow cash flow consistently and predictably. You see, over the past several years, I've been committed to helping a group of some of the sharpest entrepreneurs and business owners on the planet who are extremely committed to 2 things: exponentially growing their cash flow and having lots of fun along the way. So if you're an entrepreneur or business owner looking to have a predictable way to generate cash flow nearly on demand and explode your autonomy and freedom of choice, then you're definitely in the right place and you're going to love what I have to share with you. Now, the top 3 people who I work with fall into the following categories: small business owners, high-income professionals who specialize in their field, entrepreneurs looking for a variable source of venture capital. One of my clients, Roderick Stotts, came to me to get help with his Forex trading. He is a successful real estate and insurance professional who understood the power of having a skill set that could provide him the time freedom he was searching for as a business owner. And before meeting me, he was struggling to consistently hit profits. Since becoming my student, Roderick has not only been able to create consistent cash flow through currency trading, but he's also become a money manager for a large private investment firm. Don't take my word for it. He was kind enough to send me a video of gratitude. Let's take a listen.
Good afternoon, everyone. Just doing this little video to basically just show my appreciation for the level of service and commitment that I have received from Mr. Kevin Jefferson over at followmytrades.com. I have worked with Kevin now for a few months. We actually had a one-on-one training that we did over a two-day period of time to help me with my trading. I've been a Forex trader for a little over a year now and basically self-taught, but I had reached a point where I was not getting the amount of success that I felt I should have been getting based on, you know, what I was doing. So at that point, I realized that when you have yourself as a teacher, you have a fool. So I reached out to Kevin and let him know what my goals were, what I was trying to attain. And he sat down with me. We went over a trading strategy, a trading plan. And he sat down with me and really went over the most important thing, which was risk management. That was the key point that he really stressed, was risk management. You know, 90% of people who get into Forex trading, they typically lose their money and they blow up an account and then they're no longer trading anymore. This is something that I wanted to pursue and am pursuing as a career change that's going to give me the money, the freedom, in order for me and my family to be able to do what we want. So I realized how important it was for me to invest in myself and get the type of training that I would need to move myself to the next level. And that's what Mr. Jefferson brought to the table with me. He was able to concisely show me where it is I needed to place my focus, which was on risk management, but then also trade development, being able to put myself in a position to have a high probability trade. So what I had to do was learn from him how to identify high probability trades, meaning learning how to look at the charts and learn what the charts were actually telling me, learn what each candle was saying. And once I began to speak the language of the candle, so to speak, it was easy for me to identify high probability trades. So now I have moved my trading from, you know, only being able to capitalize a few pips here or there. Now I have developed to whereas I'm able to make larger numbers of pips, which will equal to higher amounts of pay, depending on, you know, what the pips are paying and how much you are leveraged and so on and so forth. But his plan and his style of teaching made it very easy for me to, you know, relate to what he was saying and implement what he was saying. And his plan and strategy that he devised for me, I have not deviated from, because it works. It's not that it works 100% of the time, but I mean, as a trader, you know that you can be right 50% of the time and be profitable. You just have to make your losses smaller than your wins. And that is how you go into risk management. So his process, the process that he showed me was excellent. The process was very easy to follow. It wasn't complicated at all. It's relatively simple. And just let's take a look at what my numbers are. Now let's take a look at my last 100 trades here. Okay, last 100 trades, out of the 100 trades, I won 84 out of the 100 trades, I lost 16 of the trades. So made $43 winning and lost $10 with an overall total of $32. Okay, so my trades, I had 273 pips that I won, and then I lost, you know, 78 pips, coming out with a total of 195 pips on my last 100 trades. So as you can see, these are, you know, and it's trading the US dollar, euro dollar. So this is just my last 100 trades, just to give you an idea of, you know, the consistency that I have been able to get using Kevin's methods and using his system that he taught me. So I'm very pleased. I'm very happy with the amount of time that we spent. I don't feel like he was rushing me at all, because he didn't. He ensured that before we moved on to the next step, that I completely understood the step that we were on. And that really helped me out. And I would recommend to anyone that if they are looking to grow their trading business, to have more consistency, then this program with Kevin is going to put you in that position. And so take my word for it. Take a look at my numbers. You can see that, you know, it's helped me, and I am becoming more and more successful with the help of Kevin Jefferson at followmytrades.com.
Well, you know, I'm grateful for that commentary, and I'm really grateful that I have a large number of clients who have been gracious enough to share their experiences and share with others about what we have going on over here. And I really take it seriously, helping my client partners get to where they want to be. So, you know, I want to share a little bit more about the cash flow system, because it's really simple, and I want to get into that here in a moment now. But the best thing about, let me stop this real quick. Hold on, let me see if I can move on to the next video. All right, there we go. So the best thing about the simple cash flow system is that, number one, it works with any schedule. Number two, it works with nearly any budget. And three, it's based on proven results. So this snapshot right here is not only a couple of quotes from some clients and client partners that I've helped, but this is about a week's worth of trading recently. And so this is on one of my accounts, which has made, let's say, about a $600,000 or $700,000 account at the time. And this is the numbers. These are the net numbers for the 5-day work week. So the first day of the week, I earned $52,000, a little over $52,000. Day two, I didn't trade at all. Day three, I had a small loss of a little over $18,000, close to $19,000. Day four, I created $42,496.17 in income. And then day five, which is likely a Friday, I created a little over $9,900 in income. So for a total of 5 days, $85,301.26 in cash flow. So these are the things that I'm talking about. And I know that these are the results that we're shooting for anyone who wants to join us and be a part of what we have going on. It's been my experience, and I'm sure you can agree, that there are really only two types of entrepreneurs in this business world. There are grinders who make some money sometimes and no money most of the time, and they spend way too much time making way too little. Then you've got your rainmakers. There are people who are making, you know, gobs of money, absolutely knocking it out of the park, making more and more and more money, spending less and less time, while enjoying the life that they envision, or better. So why is it that some entrepreneurs make millions, fly private, build wealth, while other business owners make less than they could in a full-time job, struggle, and spend 80 hours or more per week doing it? After talking to and observing numerous entrepreneurs and business owners, and being in this financial services industry for decades, I've realized that the rainmakers have two key things in place, while the grinders only have one, or maybe none of these things at all. And so the truth is, if you want to have both of these things in place in your ventures or business, it becomes very easy to make more reliable business financial decisions and exponentially grow your cash flow along the way if you have each of these two things. But the best way I can explain this is to share with you the story of a once less famous online bookstore, Amazon. So before I explain that, I think these five things that keep entrepreneurs and their businesses from gaining greater financial traction are worth taking a look at. So the first one is indecisiveness. Some call it analysis paralysis. Being indecisive severely limits your options. making an unwelcome outcome a self-fulfilling prophecy. Time is not your friend when failure is an option. Fail quickly so that you can get more iterations under your belt. This will give you the baseline data to make meaningful changes that can lead to a successful outcome. Every failure is a lesson and an opportunity to make higher quality decisions next time. Again, if failure is an option, fail fast and frequently so that you can create better outcomes sooner than later. Limited vision. When you can't see the proverbial forest for the trees, or when you have an idea stuck in your head and despite overwhelming evidence to the contrary, you remain in limbo, overconsidering making a change. You put your business and cash flow at greater risk. Operating in old patterns just because they're familiar does not serve your best interests. Interrupt old decision patterns by seeking outside counsel, coaching, or simply using a non-emotional data-driven approach to your affairs. Don't hide from potential flaws. Instead, seek help with them. That one act of vulnerability can change your entire business and cash flow situation for the better. None of us knows everything. Lack of creativity. Going with surface-level answers and traditional responses in a much less traditional business world carries with it significant risk. The inability to find answers outside of the proverbial box can be the difference between business breakthrough and business bankruptcy. Ask Blockbuster Video. Don't know who that is? Exactly. Low or no flexibility. Being too rigid in your approach to building certain aspects of your business, namely cash flow, can limit the speed of growth or the ability to expand into other strategic areas of your enterprise. Keep an open mind about ways to generate cash flow for your business endeavors, especially if you can do so without spending lots of time or expense when creating that cash flow. Inability to handle uncertainty and risk. I truly believe that one of the biggest advantages successful entrepreneurs and business owners have over a vast number of the general population is the ability to acknowledge and face risk and uncertainty on a daily basis. Risk management ability is hands down an entrepreneur's greatest superpower. The best way to mitigate risk is to increase your education and understanding in as many aspects as it relates to your business and your goals as humanly possible. There's a saying that pride goes before the fall. Never be too prideful to open yourself up to learn more and to grow in areas that may even intimidate you. I found in my business and life experience that confronting your hesitations and fears is the gateway to accomplishing anything you set out to conquer. Amazon dominated in many, many ways, and still does, the five characteristics of successful enterprises. The company's leadership is decisive. The company has an ever-evolving vision of the future. They are creative in how they deliver and cater to the needs and wants of their customers. They have demonstrated a keen ability to be super flexible, even to the point where one of their businesses is to get you items the same day. And their ability to handle uncertainty and risk shines through and through. Amazon endured name changes, lawsuits, and nearly 7 years of not turning a profit to becoming one of the world's most recognized and profitable companies. And I believe that a great amount of Amazon's rocky road in the beginning was not because of Jeff Bezos' understanding that he wasn't clear on what Amazon was. It was because people on the outside, the Barnes and Nobles, the Borders, and other low or no visionary companies, they weren't clear on what Amazon was, which was not an online bookstore, but a company that uses e-commerce to fulfill shareholder value in any way strategically necessary. Coincidentally, I was offered a position with Amazon back in 1999 with great starting pay, but I declined because I remember thinking, these guys aren't profitable. They were one of the few that survived the dot-com bubble and thrived thereafter. I was fooled too. Now, remember how I told you that the entrepreneurs and business owners who are knocking it out of the park have two things in place that the grinders and the struggle bunnies don't? Well, those two things, I remind you, are one, the demonstrated ability to produce positive cash flow, and two, a system that can exponentially grow that cash flow without having to spend the same amount of time and or resources that it took to do so in the first go round. Because it comes down to this: if you don't have positive cash flow, you can't afford to invest in your business's growth. If you can't afford to invest in your business's growth, you don't have a business. So, let's get down to it and show you exactly how you can get a predictable system for exponentially growing your cash flow starting today. There's only two things that matter in a venture or business, and they are One, generating positive cash flow, and two, scaling that cash flow in an efficient way. If you're not making the income that you want in your business, then let me ask you a couple questions. How long does it take for you to become cash flow positive? And how will you do it sooner next time? The rainmakers in the business game, the players with seven-figure profits and true liquid wealth, have a predictable method for generating cash flow, and they do it without fail. In the game of business, it's easy to get distracted by all of the day-to-day activities and new shiny objects. But the truth is that you only need to know these two things. One, cost to generate cash flow, and two, cost to scale that cash flow. When you have a viable business and you know these two numbers, you can plan out your cash flow growth with ease using the right system. While the grinders and the people on the struggle bus are looking to do a new rabbit trick to get a new customer so they can cover rent and are simultaneously thinking of a master plan B that involves getting another credit card if things don't work out, the rainmakers are spending a predictable amount of money to generate a predictable amount of cash flow and are using a repeatable system to scale that cash flow without having to chase a single new customer. So what does this system look like? Well, it starts with targeting profit opportunities in the currency market using a simple three-step process. Once certain conditions are met, we take our position and walk away. We return in a few days or so, collect our profit, rinse and repeat. Taking positions in the currency market, also called trading, is no different than any other business. It's all about supply and demand, and I have created a simple to follow three-step system that allows me and my students to profit when price demand occurs at certain times. Imagine being at a sports book and the bookie, or the market maker in this case, shows you their hand. Imagine that they showed you when they were going to change the betting line and you could position yourself right next to them as they shift the supply and demand of the over-under. That would be priceless because of the amount you could profit from such knowledge. Well, the three-step currency system I created is the closest thing I've seen to getting a note from the market maker about when and where they plan to move supply and demand as it relates to currency prices. It's really that simple. The result of executing this correctly is that you will have a predictable way to generate 60, 70, 80% growth on cash flow each and every year. And the best part, you can plan future projects and growth initiatives with confidence. You will finally have the accelerator that moves your business's cash flow forward when and where you need it. To execute this reliable cash flow system correctly, though, you need to get these three things in alignment, and I refer to this as the financial trifecta. These three things are mindset, methodology, and managed risk. When you have these three things in alignment, you can unlock the code and literally create amazing results, just like my client partners have experienced. I teach these three things to my students so that they can use them to financially benefit from knowing and mastering the financial trifecta. One of my client partners, Gerald Norman, whose profession is in management and leadership, completed the program and in his first month going live with the three-step cash flow strategy, grew his cash assets by 55% in 1 month's time without spending lots of time doing it. This is the text he sent me out of the blue because he was so excited. Another client, Ray, owner of a moving company, saw 31% growth in 12 days using our system for building cash flow. This is a note he sent me as well. Now again, you have to take the right system and be able to do this and get the results. You can do it the hard way, which is like going up to a lock and trying to guess the code. But did you know that there are more than 10,000 possible combinations to a four-digit lock? So you can try to crack the code by yourself, and maybe you'll find a combination that works in a year or two or three, but most likely never. Or you can do it the easier way and just get the code to unlock it and get the results immediately. And that's what I do all day in my own business and for my clients and their businesses. So your next thought is probably, how can I get a reliable cash flow system for my business that can generate 60, 70, 80% or more in additional cash flow each and every year? And the answer is, it depends. This is perfect for you if you're looking to generate greater cash flow, increase access to capital for expanding your business, reduce your workload, or gain and or maintain that freedom of choice that you started with this business and what you had dreamed in your mind when you got into this business in the first place. Because right now, I'm looking for a few of what I call client partners. A client partner to me means You get the service level worthy of a client and the commitment level worthy of a partner, with the goal of making you more successful. Where I can help you get the kinds of exponential results that I've shared. And that's why for a limited time, I'd like to have you on a cash flow strategy visit, a cash flow strategy phone visit with me, excuse me. And if you can meet certain criteria, we can work together. So I work with primarily three types of client partners. One, people who want to generate exponentially greater cash flow, who are ready to go now and don't operate from a poverty mindset, meaning that they don't major in minors or delay decisions. Two, people who want to scale their business income without adding to it more of the stresses that business owners already face. And number three, people who want to decrease their workload so that they can enjoy life, make more money, and do more things that they actually enjoy doing without all of the stress. So, here's how the process works. We will discuss your goals and how to turn them into a custom tailored strategy that you can execute to help you solve one of the biggest problems that most entrepreneurs and business owners face: generating reliable and consistent cash flow for their business without needing to add more payroll or tirelessly search for new customers, without adding customer service and accounts receivable issues, and all of the other challenges associated with customers, many of whom can be solely price driven, which to me means that they don't understand your business's true value proposition, which can be super annoying. This cash flow strategy phone visit will take around 30 minutes and you will be speaking with me personally, and I'll be helping you identify what you've already got and helping you put together a game plan to dramatically grow your business's cash flow by 60, 70, 80% or more without increasing the amount of time you spend in your business. So who is this for? Well, for me, it's for successful entrepreneurs, business owners, high-income professionals and specialists, people who typically they are generating significant revenue or income by trading time for dollars in their business or profession. This is for people who know that they're good at what they do and they want to leverage their success to create more income while they still can. It's also for people who truly value helping others and want more financial resources so that they can do it to the level they really want to do it when looking to help others. Willing to have some skin in the game and understand that they need to invest some money to grow their business and take it to that next level. Now, working with me as a client partner is not cheap, but most of my students make back more than their investment within the first month or so. And then they want to stick with me for the long haul because they see the results. So the next question is, who is this not for? This program is not for people who like the idea of starting something new because it sounds neat and you've wanted to try and dabble in it. It's not for people who make excuses and complain, especially when things don't always go their way. People who are stuck in what I call, quote unquote, information gathering mode and are not prepared to take action or to get results. And this is not for anyone who's not serious about growing their business cash flow by another $40,000 to $400,000 or more per year in the next 12 months. So now, knowing that we're a good fit is important because I like to get all of my clients results and work with them for the long haul. And to do that, I need to get them a quick ROI. And the truth is that there are some people who I can help, some people I can't. And if that's the case, I will be 100% upfront and suggest somebody else or an alternative. I'm only looking for those who are a good fit and who I'm certain I can get results for. The first step is to complete an application for a private cash flow strategy session below. This application is necessary to determine, one, that I can help you and I'm the best person to help you generate those results, and two, that you're ready to step up, commit, take action, and do what's required to generate the results. Now, once we receive your application, you'll be able to schedule a time with me to conduct your phone visit. And this is where we will really start working together to figure out what you want and how to make it happen in the fastest time possible and with the greatest ease. And then at the end of the call, one of two things will happen. You'll either be a fit and I will extend an invitation to work with me as one of my students, or if it's not a good fit, that's totally okay too, and there's no hard feelings or obligations or anything. Either way, you will receive an incredibly valuable strategy session and will walk away with newfound clarity as to where you are right now and what may be holding you back from achieving the results that you want. That, together with the exact next steps necessary to take action and break through your barriers. I expect it to be the most valuable 30 minutes you invest in your business this year. So go ahead, complete your application now, if you haven't already, and we can see how to work together. I've had a large number of inquiries about working with me, and I keep this opportunity extremely limited because of the amount of resources I commit to helping you become successful at your goals. as well as availing myself for one-to-one mentorship sessions to fast-track my students' success. So I can only work with those who I know with certainty and conviction I can generate them results and a return on their investment. So out of every 100 or so that apply with me, we may bring on 15 or 20 new members to work with on a monthly basis. With that being said, please understand that this isn't a large window of opportunity, and what I've found is that those who have the ability to make decisions and to act quickly are the most likely to get results and most likely to become my best client partners and win the cash flow game with us for years to come. So if you feel like this is right for you, go ahead, submit the form right now, then go ahead and follow the instructions on the next page. As I like to tell my students, let's have some fun. That's code for make money. Talk soon, and thanks for showing up. Not only for my sake, but for you and your business sake. I look forward to speaking with you.